Marlborough Sounds is a beautiful place. It's been the place where a lot of people have made a livelihood, either off the land or the sea. When you spent long enough in a place like this, yeah, you have an affection for it. It gets inside you, I suppose, and being able to take care of it is just something that comes naturally to a lot of people. I think everybody understands that it's important to contribute back to the environment. You can't just take, you've got to give.
Cavlock's described as the mussel capital of, or the Greenland mussel capital of the world, of New Zealand, and you can feel that. When I talk to people here, you can feel how much mussels mean to them, how much it's meant to their family, how much they want to see mussels both for aquaculture and for the environment come together. My name is Trevyn Toone.
My name is Emilee Benjamin, and I'm working on a project
trying to bring wild mussels back to the Marlborough Sounds. So they used to be very common here, and then their populations experienced a huge decline. So our goal here is to bring them back, figuring out the best way we can do that.
So the idea for the Flores Mussel Restoration Project actually came from a couple of mussel farmers. So they realised that overfishing of the wild beds in the 1960s, 70s and 80s had caused a decline, a significant decline in the wild population.
What came out of that really was the idea of perhaps restoring the local mussel beds here in the Marlborough Sounds back to something similar to what they were. I think everybody agreed that it needed to be local, because we've all got megatons of mussels. I mean, shivers, we've got 1,000 tons of mussels sitting out there right now that we could use, but we really wanted that local strain, and that's the key.
Working with the marine farmers, we developed this project so that we could put these farmed mussels back to the seafloor and try to restore the habitats, but then also to maybe jumpstart some sort of natural recovery process.
From an environmental perspective, it's a good, healthy, positive thing to do, and reasonably easy from a mussel farming perspective because they're such a robust shellfish.
So the usual mussel farming process involves these long ropes of mussels draped into the seafloor, held up by big floats, and then there'll be these large mussel harvesting boats that come up, grab one end of the rope that has all these mussels growing on it, and then they'll take that through something called a declumper or a harvester, and that will shear those mussels off of the rope, and you end up with these nice clean mussels, which is great if we want to eat them, but not so great when we want to restore them. What we have to do differently when we use mussels for restoration is that we want them to be as clumped as they can be, so that when they get on the seabed, they have the best chance of surviving.
We've had a wide variety of farmers involved in this project, and that includes Sanford for this deployment.
Today we had Simon Pooley of Just Mussels. He donated these mussels to the project.
And a lot of other companies helped us as well.
There's been all kinds of offers of knowledge and cash and in-kind support, so it's fantastic.
We harvested 5 tons of farmed mussels and helped make sure that they got to their final place for restoration.
The mussels sort of fall down and create this square sort of plot. And that's the plot that we then look to monitor. So mussels are really incredible animals. They themselves filter water and bind sediment, but they also create infrastructure on the seabed. And so when we put the mussels back to this environment that they used to be found in, it's super important because a lot of animals will move in and these mussels will create habitats, increase biodiversity, or even provide food for some animals. So when we drop down via scuba, we measure the length and the width of each plot. We put down smaller quadrats to count all of the mussels inside to look at density, which helps us determine survival. And then we also collect mussels to monitor their length and condition. Basically, we find that once we put the mussels onto the seabed, they sort of trap the sediment and bind it. We've seen really high numbers of animals moving into the beds and creating habitat, and we've even seen an increase in different fish, And then dropping down on these mussels that were just deployed yesterday, I already saw some sea cucumbers moving into the bed. We saw some triple fins sort of fluttering around. It kind of made me smile because the mussels had already been building homes even just after one day.
As a mussel farmer, and having been a mussel farmer for most of my life, it's very close to home, and to see natural mussel beds restored is probably one of the best things to happen around here.
From the perspective of Tine Tangaroa, Fisheries New Zealand, any efforts that restore and improve the Hauteva marine environment are really important. We also love this project because it's just a great example of integrating commercial activity with an environmental outcome. So we wish the marine farmers, Niwa, and everyone involved all the best.
Somebody the other day pulled in and said, "You've got a lot of marine farming companies helping you out." And I was like, yeah, it's been really, really amazing effort from everybody involved, yeah. That's my favorite part of the project.